What's up, everybody? Jeremy Weiss here with Weiss Tech Hockey, and in this video, I wanted to talk a little bit about garbage goals. Now, apparently, the term garbage goals to some people has a negative connotation. In fact, I took a little bit of flack on Twitter for it yesterday for mentioning the fact that three out of the first four goals of the Buffalo versus Philly game yesterday were, in fact, garbage goals. I don't take the term garbage goals as meaning anything negative other than, you know, the fact that it's, you know, just a hard-working blue-collar shoot and crash type of goal, which I think is great. So anyways, with the Buffalo-Philly series, especially the game yesterday, neither team is really well known for being, you know, complete finesse, beautiful goals, you know, unbelievable setups types team. They're both, you know, hard hitting, shoot and crash. Almost every shot on net, I think a lot of teams can learn from this. Almost every shot on net, they've got two or three guys crashing the net as the shot is being taken. And that's how, you know, five out of nine goals yesterday in the game were scored off garbage goals or off of, you know, shoot and crash, dig, hard nose style hockey. So I'm going to go through, play this whole set of clips through once. Go back, highlight a couple key points, and then play it through one more time at full speed, and that way you'll get a good look at it. So here we go. I'm just going to hit play here, and we'll kind of walk through. So this is the second goal of the game. And you can see it's a nice setup, but at the end of the day, it was a couple hacks at it, and finally ended up putting it in. Third goal of the game. Again, shot on net, both guys crashing the net. The guy that shot it as well as the his attacker. So two guys crashing the net on the same shot there. And here's the fourth goal of the game. Decent power play setup, but then again, look, one, two, three hacks at it. Finally, the goal goes in. So again, I mean, these are great goals. Hard-working, well-played goals, but they are, in, at least by my definition, garbage goals, meaning they're not a fancy, pretty setup with a snipe. They're just, you know, blue-collar hockey. There's a deflection, which that's not quite as garbage goal, but, you know, it's still kind of just a hard-working type goal, be in front of the net when the shot's taken. And then here's the last goal of the game, which, I mean, you've got two guys at the net, throw the puck at the net from a bad angle, and happen to pop it in. So those are the five goals we're going to kind of take a look at. Let's go back now and sort of walk through these one by one. So we'll start with the first one here. First goal, and I'm just going to kind of fast forward through to the main parts of the goal. This is actually a really nice setup. You can see what we've got here is we've got actually, I'll put it a little bit further forward, but we've got a nice triangle setup. In fact, what we've got here is the defenseman. Both defensemen are jumping into the play. So you can see we've got the triangle here. The initial shot comes from right here, but then we've got this guy that follows up into the slot. And watch how this kind of materializes here. Okay. So the puck goes on this guy's stick. He actually bobbles it once or twice and then finally ends up pounding it in. So, you know, again, that one's kind of borderline garbage. I mean, it wasn't completely garbage, but it wasn't completely clean either. There was a couple bobbles, a couple fumbles along the way, and really it was the fact that they stuck with it and kept pounding that really made it happen. Notice how many guys you've got at the front of the net here. You've got the initial shot taken. As the initial shot is being taken from this guy, you've already got two guys, one on each post, and then a third guy coming into the slot. So part of the credit goes to the fact that they kept digging, and part of the credit goes to they've got a great setup there. So that's the first goal. Fast forward through, get to the next goal here. Okay, here we go. So we get the full setup here. Now watch what we've got. This is a two-on-two with a bad angle shot. So really this shouldn't be a threat at all, except for the fact that this guy goes, you know, real hard to the net there. So let's keep this moving. So him driving that net actually pulls the defenseman with him, makes it so that this guy really kind of backs off a tiny bit, opens up some space for this guy to walk into a little bit more threatening position, but still shouldn't be too much of a threat. But watch this. Initial shot goes, and he follows up his rebound. Okay, keeps pounding. So his rebound, he follows up, and then this guy happens to be in the right spot. So Buffalo actually could have done a much better job clearing the front of the net on this. Just watch real quick. I don't think by this point there's no reason that this guy should still be standing around in front of the net. That's just my opinion. And he's the one that ends up tapping it in. Now, I'm not a color commentator here or any form of a commentator, so I apologize, but I'm not going to be calling these guys by name very often. But that's just how it goes. Okay, next goal. Okay, so this is a decent power play setup. You'll notice here, actually, on this play, I'll just kind of point this out. The fact that this guy, the guy on the point here, gets the puck here, kind of at the corner of the blue line of the boards there, starts walking, and what that does is actually pulls this guy out. He has to go out to play him. If he doesn't play him, he turns the corner and walks right in for a shot from the high slot. So because he goes out to play him, this guy pulls out into that little area vacated from where this guy left. Now he's open for a play. So the initial setup's really good. This guy reads it. As this guy pulls out, now he fires it back to this guy. Nice little kind of behind the back pass there. This guy walks in and lets it go. Now look what the setup we've got. We've already got a guy in front of the net screening the goal. We've got a guy on this side's side, and this guy is actually in the process of crashing the net right there. And you can see, again, two or three hacks at it. We've got a guy pretty much, you know, two guys on the puck, one guy on the back door in case it squirts loose there, another guy sliding into the mid slot. It's just a really good setup for just some good old-fashioned pound-at-home hockey. And that's exactly what happens. You know, they just keep hacking and hacking and hacking until it finally goes in. Now, again, this is one of those situations where I don't know why those guys were allowed to stand around for so long in front of the net without being put down. But for whatever reason, Philly was a little bit weak on putting these guys on their can, and it cost them. So there's the tying goal. So there's the first three out of four. That's the at that point is when I kind of pointed out on Twitter, most of these goals are going in garbage goals. And that's where I started getting some flack for it. So if you're offended by that term, I apologize. But in my opinion, these are nothing less than garbage goals. And I think garbage goals is a good thing. So let's keep going here. This is going to be the eighth goal of the game. Okay, this was the deflection. So nice pass back to the point. Basically just winds up and lets her rip. So, I mean, this is it's a good position to take a shot from. Not necessarily, you know, anything special, but notice what we've got. We've got Briere here in front of the net causing trouble. Incidentally, I love the way Briere plays. He's kind of a feisty little guy and causes a lot of trouble. Gets people thinking about him instead of the game. And in this situation, he managed to get a nice little stick on it, deflect the puck in. So great goal there. But again, you know, nothing too crazy. Just get to the right spot, do the right thing at the right time, and make it happen. So there's Briere for the eighth goal of the game. And then here's Buffalo's final goal. Okay, puck comes back behind the net. Bad angle, shovel it on net. You've already got a guy actually in the crease and another guy here waiting to put something in. Two or three hacks at it, and it goes in. Let's go ahead and take one more look at the full set of clips, and then we'll be on our way. So that's it. So make sure you check back on our blog, WeisTechHockey.com/blog, for more NHL dissections, as well as drills and skills and all kinds of other good hockey material.